Hi everyone, Sunday Christopher Mwamusa here, and I'm your regular host of The Power of Journalism, but that is not the reason I'm here today. Today I want to quickly talk about what is happening in Nigeria right now. Now, a lot of Nigerian youths have taken to the streets to express their displeasure and dissatisfaction. A unit in the Nigerian Police Force, SARS, is an acronym for Special Anti-Robbery Squad. Now, this Special Anti-Robbery Squad, I think, was created so many years ago, some decades ago. I mean, it should be between 1992 or 1984, but it has been created, recreated, branded, rebranded over time. But it started some years ago. They were created to actually operate covertly. And they were supposed to fight crime, robbery, kidnapping, and some other crimes, not financial crimes, because we have another unit for that, which is called the EFCC. But over the years, Nigerian youths have been complaining about this police unit. They have been complaining of extortion. They have been complaining. In short, let me not use the word they have been complaining, because this is something we see. Like almost every day, we see these things on social media. People are uploading videos of this same police unit extorting money from the youths. Sometimes they even go to the extent of shooting them at will. And they do this with impunity. I've seen videos where they say, "I'll shoot you and nothing will happen." And the truth is that whenever these youths are actually shot by these police officers, nothing actually happens. So these people have changed their modus operandi from fighting or combating crime, maybe covertly, to embarrassing and extorting money from the youths, from the Nigerian youths.
Hi guys, it's my dad.
Yes, of course, they know who I am.
My dad, Christopher.
Yeah.
And I just want to be here for fun.
Okay, sweetheart, can I continue?
You're talking about something very, very important in Nigeria. And it's very, very important.
Okay, they know it's important, sweetheart. So can I continue?
Yeah.
Okay, sweetheart, thank you. Bye-bye. Shut the door. Thank you. So sorry, it happens like this when I'm trying to record from home. As I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, this police unit has been extorting money from the Nigerian youths. Now, they harass them on the streets when they see people looking good, when they see people driving, these youths driving nice cars or having some nice phones and all that. Now, I'm not against the police doing their job, but I think the job of the police should be done properly. You know, now people are even more scared of this police unit. They are scared of this police unit more than the armed robbers or the criminals. Because, for example, if an armed robber kills someone, okay, there's maybe 2/10 possibility that he may be caught and brought to justice. Maybe, just maybe. But when these police officers, when they kill, there is no possibility, there is no guarantee that this officer will be prosecuted. So it has happened over time that these people, they kill with impunity, they kill at will. They go to the streets and shoot them with live ammunition. Now, who does that? Who does that? These people are protesting. Now, they want the attention of the leaders. So which means that someone should come out and speak with them and tell them that, okay, we have heard you. We've heard what you say. The president has actually not spoken about this. Like, he has not done any. I know that his aides have spoken, but the president is nowhere to be found. We just see him. He's appointing an INEC chairperson or whatever. You know, so the thing is that he takes the people, Nigerians, he takes Nigerians for granted. And he doesn't give two hoots about us. And that is what I think. That's my opinion. And now the FCT Security Committee, under the guise of COVID, prohibits street protests. Like, they had a security meeting and said that, okay, there should be no protest in Nigeria because of COVID-19. And this is the same security committee that has technically defeated Boko Haram. This is the same security committee that have not been able to guarantee security for the Nigerian citizens. But right now, it was very quick for them to have their security meeting to be able to stop these protesters from going out there to fight for what is right. Today, in Benin City, someone was killed. Because now, for some days now, I don't know who are bankrolling these thugs. So when these people, when these youths are out protesting, some thugs are out also to attack the protesters.
In any form of violence. Yeah. They just collected his phone and they brutalized his head.
Of course.
You see, whoever is actually exposing this person should know that Nigerian youth will not take this.
My name is Shedrack. We've been here for a peaceful process this morning. And unfortunately, in less than some minutes, thugs came from nowhere with machetes and guns, local made guns. They attack us.
We don't say that they should go. They don't go pay all those people money.
So it's so funny that we don't know who is who, and they come out, we don't know who's bankrolling them. I mean, how it's insane that some group of people would come out to attack protesters. So you see the effrontery, you see the boldness. So it shows that there are people who are actually behind these people who go out to attack protesters. And now it's the same thing that happened in Benin today. Someone was killed. Someone was killed. This time, not by the police, but by thugs who had been paid to come and attack. So now, I think this thing is now becoming a political hoo-ha. Now, the police are killing the protesters, and thugs who have been paid by some group of people are also killing in Benin City today. The picture is so gory. I mean, like, I saw the picture, I have the video. It's so gory. How could someone, I mean, a fellow human, you see a brother, a friend, someone who speaks the same language, someone who bears the same passport, he's fighting for his right. He has not attacked you because you have collected money from whoever sent you. You just come and attack and kill an innocent person. That is not right. And the government is supposed to provide security for these protesters. That is how it's supposed to be. They are supposed to be secured, not to be killed. So I would really want the government, I'm urging the government to do what they have never done before. The Nigerian government have never, and I don't know if they will ever consider the lives of the Nigerian citizen to be important. They just care about themselves. It has been the same from the beginning. So I would really implore them to please just do this for once. Be responsible for once. Be a government for once. Care about your citizen. Try to do what you have never done before. It's 2020. Please try to do this for once. You have never done this before, but it will do you good. The world will see you as a developed, a civilized country for once. Do what every sane society would do. Please protect your citizen. Stop the killings. Reform the Nigerian police. Please. Thank you very much.